Even if you've never heard of his restaurants, you probably know Mario Batali's name. He is one of the most recognized and respected chefs in the whole wide world. Batali's empire includes 25 restaurants, 10 cookbooks, 3 Italy markets, and several TV shows. He won the James Beard Award back in 2005 as Outstanding Chef of the Year. 3 years later, the Beard Foundation named him Restaurateur of the Year. And next week, thousands of restaurant food trucks and bars will join Bono's annual Red Campaign to fight AIDS. Batali kicks things off Sunday with a Red Supper on Pier 26 in New York City. Good morning to you, Chef.
Good morning and happy to be here, guys.
We are glad to have you. So Bono recruited you. What did he say to you 2 years ago to get you involved in the... What was his pitch to you?
Well, he knows that my fundamental charitable move is to help children become their best children that they can be. And in America, we kind of just assume they're going to be born more or less healthy. In Africa, the idea is that they're not even, they don't really stand a chance to be even born without AIDS. So he said, how about we just save a bunch of lives to give Africa, the emerging continent, some real potential? And I said, of course I'll join you, whatever. If he said he wanted to march around with a yellow popsicle stick, I'd say a yes to.
And so how are you going to do this?
We kick off with a dinner on Sunday the 31st on Pier 26, and you can go to Gilt to find, still there are tickets available. We have the Roots playing, we have a bunch of chefs all cooking a dinner for 1,000. It's called the Red Supper presented by Infinity. And all we do is cook this magnificent dinner and then listen to the Roots. And then the rest of the month, all of June, each of the participating restaurants, food trucks, and bars has a red item, whether it's a cocktail, an appetizer, a dish, or anything involved with red. And part of those proceeds go toward the global fund that was started by Shriver and Bono back, mm-hmm. 10 years ago.
And you personally recruited the chefs that are going to participate on
Sunday. As many as I could get my cell phone on, I recruited. And even people I don't know, and they will subsequently become my best friends, because they're really doing something that matters. And that's how kind of the teamwork that unites the hospitality industry becomes something very evident and really great.
You mentioned something that matters. It seems like nowadays cooking is cool. But you were here before everyone else said, this is something I could be a celebrity at. This is something that I could use for a certain purpose. When you started off as a chef, did you have intentions? Did you have thoughts of any of that?
I became a chef, and I tell all the kids I meet, if you find something that you love, you will never feel like you're going to work. So I became a chef because after I studied Spanish theater of the Golden Age and finance theory in college, I realized neither of those were career moves for me, but that the cooking that I did growing up was something that I loved. And if you find that, whatever it is, then you're always going to be happier. So cooking became cool, but keep in mind, when I became a cook, it was the last thing you did after you got fired from your landscaping job before you went to jail.
Yeah. But do you have time to cook now because you've got so many restaurants?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I don't have to clean up is the best thing about my position now. I can walk into a kitchen if friends or somebody that I like or somebody that I want to make something special for. I walk in, I cook right on the line, I send them out the dish, and then I can saunter back out in the dining room immediately.
Yeah, what's your favorite thing to cook at home for your kids?
My favorite thing to cook in general...
Because it's like you're standing your home for dinner every night.
Yes, well, that's the beauty of working in New York City. I have all of my restaurants and a Vespa, much like Charlie, and we can get to a lot of places very quickly and then get home in time for dinner and then go back and people didn't even know I wasn't there for a minute. My favorite thing always, historically, has been to make breakfast for my children, because when it's... They're just waking up and they're just a little bleary-eyed. You can get a little bit more of the truth out of them if you question them properly, which is a great way.
You spoiled them for breakfast.
Yeah, well, I had the Batali Brothers breakfast menu for many years, which had 15 items on it, and I would make, no matter what it was, it came with a complimentary vitamin and a glass of juice.
What's happening in the restaurant business? What kinds of food, what kinds of cuisine is sort of trending?
I think particularly in America, I think as Americans become more well-traveled and more savvy about the interesting things going on around the world, authenticity becomes something we're looking for. And as we understand and as we've learned in the last 20 years, Italian food isn't just spaghetti, pasta, and spaghetti, pizza, and lasagna. There's 21 regions in Italy, each of which have another 10 or 20 different, very interesting spaces. And as you travel around the world, you realize Moroccan food isn't anything. There's Northern Moroccan food, there's the Atlas Mountains Moroccan food, and as we search for that, and as people bring back their own take on that, food becomes as intellectually satisfying as it is physically and nutritionally satisfying. And that's why the restaurant industry is kind of cool right now, because we've become the entertainment, because people are fascinated by many facets of our business.
Beyond passion, what's the most important thing that a good chef has to know?
They have to know how to treat people right to be able to maximize their potential. You need to build teams. You need to have a group of people who are working very hard in a hot environment in the least comfortable room of the entire building. And they need to know that they're working toward a common goal, which is both for the customer's satisfaction, but also for their own satisfaction. You need to find a way. We spent We used to spend 100% of our time on guest satisfaction. Now we spend 50% of our time on guest satisfaction and 50% of our time on employee satisfaction, because a happy team is a much better way to run your business.
You encouraged Gwyneth Paltrow to do the food stamp challenge, and that didn't work out so well. And then she ended up being criticized for it, Mario. What are your thoughts about that? And I'm sure
I don't know that press, because obviously in Gwyneth's life, trying to stay on a food stamp budget was she could have probably done it, but she goes out to dinner where people ply her with expensive champagnes and magnificent dishes. At the end of the day, she handled the brouhaha quite nicely. And at the real end of the day, it probably raised the visibility of the food stamp problem in a much better way than just simply having her be successful.
Thank you so much, Mary. Great to have you.
All right, thanks.
Really good to see you.